Mr. Excel Podcast, sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1715. We're going to find AutoRecover or Autosave files. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I was working on a situation yesterday, and I kind of panicked. You know, I have a computer that stays on 24/7, and I have a file there of just my to-do list, right? And this to-do list runs, you know, I keep the list running for a month, crossing stuff off and so on. And I never really think to close that file. And on Monday, I'm kind of embarrassed to say this, that file had been open for a month, and it had last been saved maybe 5 or 6 days ago, right? So this is the same instance of Excel that's been open for a long, long, long time. I never even think about saving this file because I'm always adding to it, and you know, just on and on and on. And I get a question, the red fox question from yesterday, right? And I said, oh, this is going to be easy. This is a quick little macro. I said, oh, well, that's going to be easy. I wrote the macro, and the macro is working, but it's not working for the second item. So I just add a couple of lines of code. And now, in retrospect, I realize those codes were really, really bad because it was counting on this WF variable to get reset, and it wasn't getting reset. I didn't have WF equals to zero. But I had just added just a couple lines of code, and so I didn't think to save this file. I didn't think to save the other file. I just said, oh, yeah, let's run it. Type in the word, and oh, right away, I realized something bad. I mean, this macro should run in a couple of seconds, and I've thrown it into a loop. I'm waiting for it to finish, you know, trying to think, what did I do? Oh no. And normally we could get out of a macro with Ctrl+Break or escape, right? But it's now in this not running state, so Ctrl+Break, or I'll press escape, you know, it's not responding to me. It's not responding to me. And that's no big deal because it was just a couple of lines of code, and I actually was working on the main desktop PC, not the podcast PC, so I knew that I'd have to take this and recreate it, you know, take me a few minutes, not a big deal. But then I started to panic. Oh no, my other file, my to-do list file that's been open for 5 days, when was the last time that was saved? And is autosave still working, or did I get one of those annoying messages, hey, we've disabled autorecover for the remainder of this session? You know, I don't know, several days. And so, you know, I come out here and try and do the escape thing. You know, now it's not responding, and Ctrl+Break, it's not responding. Rory at the Mr. Excel message board said, just try and hold down escape for a long time. So right now I'm pressing the escape key. Nothing, right? Nothing. And I'm like, oh no. Now, of course, I could Ctrl+Alt+Delete and go to the task manager, and in the task manager, I can end the Excel process. But that, unfortunately, is going to end, you know, both the macro that I just created and this file that's been open for days and days and days. And so I really wanted to make sure before I did that I wasn't going to lose a lot of information. So the question comes up, where is AutoRecover saved? All right, and here's where we find it. So I'm going to do the flying Windows key and E to get to Windows Explorer. Up here I'm going to type percent APPDATA, all one word, percent, which is a shortcut to your application data folder, and then Microsoft, and then Excel. Now I had never really been to this folder until, you know, I was panicking, and here's the file name, AA file for podcast 1715. Oh my gosh. And it looks like it's been updated to 1714, and if you can see down here my taskbar, it's currently 721. So it looks like there was a recent autosave. I will go in here, yeah, there was a autosave at 628, 640, 702, 714. So that's all good, 714. So it looks like I've lost 7 minutes worth of work. How much did I lose? I actually copied this, Ctrl+C to copy. Go out to another folder where I usually just store some work files, and we'll paste there, right click and paste. Okay, and you can actually open this in a second instance of Excel. Now I have Excel 2010 and Excel 2013 here, so I was able to go to Excel 2013, read only, and there's the file. Now it's interesting, it opens as read only. right, so at least I can see, you know, hey, I made this note at 7:13 a.m. All right, so I started to breathe easier because I knew that, sure enough, the file was still there. I did make a second copy of the file, file save as, and notice it changes it back to an XLSB, even though mine is always an XLSM, and just backup to-do file. All right, so now I can close this Excel file, close, Alt FX, and now when I force a restart here, Control Alt Delete, start the task manager. I'm just going to kill the Excel process instead of so end process. Bam. All right, and then you know, you always hope that AutoRecover is going to be available again, but you never really know, and yeah, sure enough, it was there. The AutoRecover files are there. So before I killed Excel, I wanted to make sure that the AutoRecover files were there. And it turns out that all of this information is from the last AutoRecover. All of this information is under File Option Save. You can control the AutoRecover file location and even how many minutes it was saved, and keep the last autosave version if I close without saving. So all of these are the default. You can go in and change this. Of course, you know, the problem is you can't check this once your computer is locked up. Hey, and finally, you know, have you ever gotten stuck with a macro in a loop and it's not responding to Control Break, and you found some magic way to make it respond to Control Break or to escape? That would be great information to know as well. All right, there you go. How to find the auto-recovered files before you kill Excel to make sure that the data that you need is really there. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.